Hi, welcome to our technical video series on how to build custom decentralized applications with the Horizon sidechain technology. We call it Zendu. This is the third episode of this video series. In the last episode, we discussed the first Horizon sidechain SDK macro elements group of boxes, box data, propositions, and proofs. In this video, I'm going to tell you about sidechain SDK transactions. We will look at how they are organized inside and how to implement custom transactions following the Lambo registry application as an example. Transactions are one of the most important aspects of any sidechain. They are made up of inputs and outputs. Inputs go into a transaction. Roughly speaking, sidechain sends inputs, and outputs come out, making up what is received. Simply speaking, blockchain sends the inputs, and what is received on the other end is the output. The outputs of one transaction can then be spent as the inputs of another one. Let's go to the Lambo registry code and see how to implement custom transactions. In Lambo registry, we introduced three transactions, one to declare a new car, one to put it on sale at a given price, and one to complete the purchase or cancel the sell order. As in most of the real-world use cases, you must pay a fee to complete a transaction. For this reason, all Lambo registry transactions must be able to spend CoinBox inputs as a source to pay the transaction fees and receive the difference or receive change back by creating new CoinBoxes as output. The car buy order will use the same mechanism to pay for the car. The SDK introduces an implementation of a CoinBox with the regular box class. In the Lambo registry, we introduced a base class named Abstract Regular Transaction that implements all the common logic required to manage regular boxes. Its constructor accepts regular box IDs to be spent, the corresponding signatures, the possible change represented by regular box data outputs, and the fee and timestamp. Transactional inputs are represented as a list of box unlockers. The box unlocker interface indicates the ID of the box to be spent and the proof which demonstrates the right to spend it. Abstract regular transaction takes care of implementing the unlockers method by returning the list of the unlockers to the regular boxes that have been spent. The new boxes implementation returns the list of newly created regular boxes and calculates and assigns the proper nonce to make the box unique. The deterministic rule for output box nonces is defined inside the parent sidechain transaction class in the getNewBoxNonce method and validated in the semantic validity method. But you don't need to worry about this, as it is managed directly by the SDK core. There is a default implementation returning the transaction fees and timestamp specified in the constructor. Abstract regular transaction already implements the basic stateless checks in the transaction semantic validity method. For example, it checks that fees and the timestamp are greater than zero, and so on. The car declaration transaction was created to allow the declaration of a brand new car. In Lambo registry, anyone can create a brand new car, but in a real-world scenario, this process will follow different rules. Car declaration transaction extends abstract regular transaction to reuse all the common logic that was described before. As we said before, car declaration transaction adds the ability to declare a single car token that is represented as a car box and the corresponding car box data. The car declaration transaction constructor takes the same arguments of abstract regular transaction plus the instance of car box data to be created. The new boxes method reuses the abstract regular transaction base implementation, but appends to the list of newly created boxes the car box entry that has to be declared. There's no need to extend the unlockers method because we are just spending regular boxes during the car declaration. Sell car transaction enables you to create a sell order for a specific car token. It spends a car box and regular boxes as transaction fees. To create change for the transaction fees, it creates a sell order box with exactly the same car information and sales data. For example, the price and the buyer's detail. Like the car declaration transaction, it extends abstract regular transaction class. The sell car transaction constructor takes the same arguments of abstract regular transaction plus an instance of car sell order info. Car sale order info contains the information related to the car box to be spent and the additional data required to create the car sale order box. More specifically, it consists of a car box, a proof for this box, the desired price for the car, and the buyer's public key. Turning back to the sell car transaction, we can see how the unlockers and new boxes methods were overridden. For unlockers, we call the base class method and append the unlocker needed to open the car box previously defined in the car sell order info. Similarly to the unlockers method, we append the sell order box defined car sell order info, what was returned by the base class new boxes method. That's all for today. In this video, we saw how straightforward it is to introduce custom transactions, following the Lambo Registry application as an example. This and even more information can be found in the Sidechain SDK and Lambo Registry GitHub repos, and in our documentation web portal. Thanks for watching, and see you soon.